This time on Film Wrecker, we are looking at Taika Waititi. With the release of Jojo Rabbit, the Kiwi filmmaker has made six films, all of which are terrific. Whether it is huge budget or a local film with friends, there's legitimately not one misstep, but we are still going to count them down from best to more best. Number six, Eagle versus Shark. Eagle vs. Shark is kind of what you remember Napoleon Dynamite being, but with a bit more depth. It sadly flew under the radar, but this bittersweet story is well worth tracking down. Jermaine Clement is especially terrific as a kind of loser kind of hero who's too scared to let anyone in. It's so funny and so sad all at once. The low budget is actually kind of a plus for most of it. The homemade costumes and low rent sets add to the movie. The only reason this is at the bottom is that even though Waititi started off on a high note, he just kept getting better. Number five, What We Do in the Shadows. It spawned a TV show and a stage show, so it should come as no surprise that it is excellent. This mockumentary about vampires in Wellington, New Zealand feels a lot like Waititi just goofing around with his friends, because it basically is Waititi goofing around with his friends. It's a really fun mix of vampire tropes all thrown together and then made as Kiwi as humanly possible. It probably helps if you've been to New Zealand, and specifically to Wellington, but even if you haven't, the deadpan delivery and documentary style is hilarious, not to mention Rhys Darby's excellent cameo as the leader of the werewolves. Number four, Boy. This was the highest-grossing New Zealand film for years, at least until Waititi beat his own record, and it is easy to see why. It's charming and funny and sweet in a way that's specifically New Zealand. Taika is great as the not-so-cool-as-he-thinks-he-is dad, but it's really the kid that shines. James Rolleston is fantastic. Waititi's exceptionally good with child actors and with capturing the awkwardness of childhood in general. Sadly, this movie flew under the radar in the rest of the world, but if you haven't seen it, find it and change that. Number three, Jojo Rabbit. Waititi is maybe the best at working with kids of any current director. He has an excellent sense for capturing what it is to be a kid while also delving into bigger questions. It's that moment between holding on to innocence and growing up too quickly. Jojo Rabbit is maybe the best example. The stories about a young Nazi who befriends the Jewish girl in his attic, much to the dismay of his imaginary friend Adolf Hitler. It is as funny as you would expect for a Waititi movie, but it also has the poignance that you would expect from a World War II movie. Sam Rockwell is especially great as the closeted Hitler youth leader in a turn that is kind of reminiscent of his character in the terrific movie The Way, Way Back. Number two, Thor Ragnarok. Waititi was a huge surprise choice to pick up the reins for the third Thor movie, but he far surpassed expectations. Thor Ragnarok gives Guardians of the Galaxy a run for its money as the funniest Marvel movie. It's a pretty simple buddy movie at its core with a bit of a riff on Spartacus via the amazing Planet Hulk comic book run. This film gave Chris Hemsworth the chance to show us how funny he is, while playing against solid turns from Mark Ruffalo, Tessa Thompson, Jeff Goldblum, and Waititi himself, amongst others. It's packed from end to end with everything you could want in an action movie, and the effects are miles beyond anything any of us thought that Waititi had up his sleeve. Number one, Hunt for the Wilder People. Number one is maybe the most stereotypically Taika Waititi of any of his movies. It stars an awkward kid who is trying too hard, played by Julian Dennison, who later went on to be awesome in Deadpool 2, and who ends up on the run with the hilariously grumpy Sam Neill. It's very New Zealand, with guest spots from Waititi regulars like Rhys Darby and Rachel House. It hits that perfect spot between endearing and funny. And in a lot of ways, Wilder People is to Waititi what E.T. was to Spielberg. And that's it. If you haven't seen any of these movies, go and watch them. I can't stress enough that all six films are terrific. You could probably argue for any of them at number one. If you haven't yet, please like and subscribe, and hopefully I'll see you all next time.